Hello friends, welcome to my next video tutorial on Java for Beginners. In this video, I am going to start discussion about list interface. As I told in my last video, collection framework is a framework that provides architecture to store and to handle the group of objects. It has interfaces and its implementation classes plus some algorithms. Now in this video, let's start discussion about collection framework interfaces. From that, first we will discuss about what is list interface. A list interface is derived from collection interface. It represents a group of objects which is arranged just like an array. Here in list interface, insertion order of the objects must be preserved. In which order we added? In the same order, only the objects should be saved. Also here we can see this is a index 0, 1, 2 up to 9. So first object is going to be placed at 0th index, second object is going to be placed at first index, third object at second index, and so on. After that, here is the last object. So I can say we can maintain the insertion order by using index. If you notice here, there are duplicate objects also. Here one car object and here also same car object. So it is a duplicate. Then how we can differentiate? We can differentiate by means of index. This car object is located at 0th index and this car object is located at 7th index. So I can say list interface allow duplicate values to be stored, and by using the index we can able to differentiate duplicates. Correct? So these are the properties of list interface. We know that list interface extends from collection. Hence it supports by default all the methods of collection and along with some additional specific methods which are present in list interface. So what are the methods are there in the list interface? Let us discuss now. First we will talk about those methods which are access object based on their index position. Like simple example, here I am creating a list of string type using ArrayList. I will discuss about this ArrayList in my next video. Right now let us consider this is a list, let's say L1. If I want to add an object, for example car, for first time, this object will be added at 0th position. After that I want to add another object, bus, so this time it will add at the next position, that is here first index, right? So next object will add it automatically to the next position. So till now we have added 3 objects in list 1. To check this, just write L1 in system.out.println method and just run the program. So we can see here all the 3 elements are printed. Okay, so here all the elements are added by default to the next position. But if I want to add objects at a specific position, for example I want to add at 5th location, then we need to write a list interface contain specific method void add, and inside that I have int index comma object o. It means I want to add this object at the specified index, then we need to use this method. Let's see, simple example. Here I want to create one more list, let's say L2. If I want to add an object, let's say bike at location 0, for that I am going to write L2.addIndex0,bike. So bike object will store at location 0 index in L2 list. Similarly, I am going to add cycle object at index 1. Okay, then we will print the list L2. So just run this program. We can see here both the elements are stored at mentioned locations. So with this method, we can add object at a specific location. Suppose I want to add a group of objects, not single object, group of objects. For that I will write this method, boolean add all, and inside that we have to pass int index comma collection c, means a group of object from this index onwards add all. For example, let's say I want to add all the objects from list L2 to list L1 from index 2 onwards. For that I have written L1.addAll and passing index value 2 comma L2 list name. Okay, so this method add all L2 objects from index 2 onwards in L1 list. To check this, just print here updated list L1 and run the program. So here we can see list L1 is updated. In here these two objects are added in between at index 2 and 3. And please note that the object which was there at index 2 in L1 list is shifted to 4th index. So this method add all the objects from specified collections to the list. First object from the collection list gets inserted at given index. If there is already an object at that position, then that element and other subsequent elements are shifted to the right by increasing their index value. Okay, so this is about addition of objects. Now suppose if I want to remove some objects from the list, for that we can use this method, object remove, and we are passing index value. For example, let's say I have this list L1, and from this list I want to remove object from index 1. For that I have written L1.remove and we are passing index 1 value. So this method remove objects from index 1 location in list L1. To check this, just print here updated list L1 and run the program. So we can see here in updated list L1, bus object is removed from index 1 and the subsequent objects are shifted to left side. Their index are decreased by 1. For example, bike is shifted left from index 2 to 1. Cycle object is shifted from index 3 to index 2. Train object is shifted left from index 4 to index 3. Understood? So we can say this method removes an object from the specified index. It shifts subsequent objects, if any object are there, to the left side, and it decreases their index by 1. Okay, apart from these three methods, based on their index position, we have two more methods. These are object get and passing index value, and another method is object set, and inside that we are passing index value comma new object. First, we'll talk about this method. This method returns object at the specified index. To understand this method in a better way, let us consider one example. Let's say I have this list L1, and from this list I want to get object from index 3. So for that I have written L1.get, and we are passing value 3 inside the system.out.println method to get the object from index 3. Now just run the program. We can see here we get the object train, which is present at index 3. And this another method which will replace objects at given index with new object. This method returns the object which was just replaced by new object. For example, let's say I want to replace object at index 3 with new object bike. For that I have written L1.set3, bike, and then just print the updated list. Let's run the program. This is the updated L1 list. Here train object is replaced by bike object at index 3. Okay, so these are the 5 methods which is helpful to add, delete, or we want to set, or we want to get objects based on the index position in the list interface. Apart from that, list interface also provides methods which is helpful for searching objects from the list, and these methods return object index position. So these two methods are int index of, and we are passing object, and another method is int last index of, and we are passing object. First, we'll discuss about this method. This method returns first occurrence of given object. If object is not found in the list, it returns -1. To understand this method in a better way, let us consider one example. Let's say I want to search two objects, bike and bus. Where these two objects are located, for that I have written two statements. In this statement, I have written L1.index of, and we are passing bike object. And in second statement, I am writing L1.index of, and we are passing bus object. Now just run the program, and here we can see index of bike is 1. It means bike object is located at index 1, and index of bus is showing -1. It means bus object is not present in the list, that's why it is showing -1. Okay, and we have another searching method. This method returns the last occurrence of given object. If any object is not found in the list, it returns -1. To understand this method in a better way, let us consider one example. So here I want to search object car. To get the last occurrence of this object car, for that I have written this statement. Here I am writing L1.lastindex of, and we are passing car object. Okay, now just run the program. So here we can see last index of car is 3. It means we can see car object is present in two places, at location 1 and at location 3. So we called last location index method, that's why it is showing last index, which is 3, where the car object is located at second time as well as at the last time. After that, there is no occurrence of car object in this list. Okay, so these are the two methods which are used for searching object from the list. List interface have another method to get the list of objects from some range. For example, from index 1 to index 4. For that, we have this method, which is useful to get the list view from this index to this index. To understand better, let's say I have this list L1, and from this list I want to get objects from index 1 to index 4. For that, I have written range equal to L1.sublist, and we are passing index 1, index 4. And after that, let's print this range. Just run the program. So here we can see we get the object list. In that, we have bike, cycle and bus object. Please check here carefully. We get the object from index 1, which is bike, index 2, which is cycle, and from index 3, which is bus, but not from the index 4. Why? Because the range we have mentioned 1 to 4 means we can get the object from index 1 to index 3. Here index 4 object is excluded. So always remember, this index position value is excluded from the list. It means we get the object just before value of last index position. Right? So I can say this method returns list view of a specified list between from index which is inclusive and to index which is exclusive. Okay. Now, apart from these many methods, list interface also provide one more method to retrieve objects one by one. That is list iterator. This method returns list iterator object. It is a special case of iterator, which is bidirectional iterator. Regarding this, I will discuss in detail in another video in which I have discussed about iterator. So please check in my playlist for more details about iterators. So in this video, I have discussed about list interface and these list interface methods. In my next video, we will start discussion in detail about list interface implementation classes of collection framework. I hope you understood the concept and enjoyed this video. Request you to please share, like and subscribe this video. Thank you.